Hello and welcome to Newsclick. Today we have with us Harsh Mander, who's been covering India with Karwan E Mohabbat. Harsh, this has been a discovery of some kind. Why did you start this project at all? Why did you go to these places?
See, the two things that are troubling me very much about India, I think about much of the world, but particularly India since we live here. One is that you're seeing a rising climate of hate. I call it command hate because it is hate that is actually politically sort of generated and legitimized.
It has a specific purpose.
And it is legitimized. So there's a legitimization, a permissive environment led from the top for hate speech and hate violence of a kind that we've never seen since partition.
This is normalization of hatred and violence.
Absolutely. And targeting. And as a result of that, especially our Muslim minorities, Christian tribal minorities, Dalits in many places, are living with fear as an everyday aspect of life. Those of us who are not in these communities don't even realize. I mean, Muslim colleagues, for instance, are telling me, their mothers will tell them, you know, if you're on a train, if I ring up, don't say salam alaikum, say namaste. You know, don't let people know that you are Muslim. So you're living continuously in a sense of everyday fear. So that is one part. And I think that it's really important for us to reach out, to say that this is happening and to also express solidarity, that you're not alone. It's not a problem of the minorities, it's a problem of all of us, of what kind of society we want. But the other part is the silence of the majority. The idea, you know, that there is, compared even to the United States, where post-Trump, we see so much, when you look at film award functions, or you look at, you know, television, you look at commentators, you look at everyday people, you know, coming to airports and saying, you know, we oppose the Muslim ban. We're not seeing that kind of pushback by the majority community in India. There's a substantial silence, and the silence can either be out of, because of fear, because of indifference, or actually sharing that feeling of hate.
And so you think there is a complicity in the silence?
There's a complicity in the silence. So in very brief, I feel that we need to do something continuously in this climate of hate. One is a voice of solidarity, and the other is a call of conscience.
Karwan E Mohabbat went to places where there is violence. We have covered some of that when your team went around to different places. So what did you see which was the most striking aspect of this? As a consequence of your visits, what do you think is a long-term follow-up that all of us can do?
See, you know, it's a long conversation, but I'll just sort of earmark three or four biggest findings that we did when we traveled across 8 states last September in the Karwan. The first of us is the extent of hate. You know, once again, after the Karwan, when Afrazul was killed, I mean, I went there and I found that he never knew the man. He never met him in his life. And you see him for 30 seconds and you kill him with that brutality. A lot of the other killings that people have been talking about, you not only kill, you lynch somebody, the bodies are mutilated. The amount of hatred that has got unleashed, I think that is one. The videographing, this is almost, you know, that you do it and you videograph it, is common across the country. So it's almost like you're doing this as a public entertainment, also a message to the community about where they stand. So this is one part that we found. The second was the role of the police consistently across, that the police in almost every case actually registers cases against the victim and protects the accused. And so this environment of permissive violence is reinforced all of that time by the state, very clearly. And the third big thing is the complete absence of compassion or solidarity in local areas by the majority community. The complete silence. I mean, again, because Afrazul's is most recent, I went to Rajsamand 3 days, 4 days after. I mean, it's happened in a district town, 700 meters from where the collector sits, and so on. I've been a district collector. I know in small town India, in normal times there would be a response, but nobody speaks out, nobody reaches out. It is as if it's a problem of the Muslim community and they have to deal with it themselves. So the failure to express outrage and compassion, right from our Prime Minister downwards, nobody is actually saying they care. And I think, so these are the three big things that I found through all of this journey, which is why it is so necessary for us to continue this work.
So for all of us, what is it, what are the next steps? Of course, resistance in different forms, different ways, are things groups are trying. There are solidarity actions that are taking place. But in terms of the big picture, what is it that you would like to do as a follow-up to the Karwan E Mohabbat?
I feel that both solidarity and conscience have to be, have to be consistent long-term actions that we have to do around this climate of hatred and fear. And we have to find almost a new grammar of politics, I think, which is founded on ideas of solidarity and love. And these are difficult. These are new things that we are trying to do. And so we decided that we would, continue this journey through at least all of 2018. I hope we will have the energy and the capacity to continue doing it. We thought we'll visit at least one state every month and do the same thing. Visit families that have been affected by hate violence, saying to them that we care and that we stand with you, you're not alone. Look at the issues of justice in relation to those cases, and also inform, write, speak. So we're looking for writers, especially, whom we call chroniclers, writers, photographers, videographers, who will tell the story. Newsclick, we hope, will be part of the entire journey. So this is one thing that we've decided to do. Second is we're trying to support work in terms of documentation for the scale of hate violence. I mean, there's so much denial. In the Rajya Sabha, they were asked how many incidents of mass mob violence, and they reported two from January to July 2017. In December, they gave this reply. I'm so appalled by the lie that they're telling us that there are two incidents of mob. So we have to also document the scale of hate violence in our country as a second thing. But the third is, I think, that we generally need to talk a lot more about our imagination of the good society. And I think that secularism is not something that we have to be defensive about. It's something that we need to talk about with pride. This is the India which belongs equally to people of every faith and every caste and class and gender and so on.
Last question. Replication at the local level, do you see some prospects of this being many more of similar exercises across the country?
Absolutely. In two ways. I mean, I feel that every time we're going to a new state, it's very often, I mean, there's some states like Rajasthan and Gujarat where there's a lot of civil society action that we already saw. But in a lot of the other states, Assam, coastal Karnataka, Jharkhand, Western UP, Uttar Pradesh, we're finding that the process, Madhya Pradesh now, Odisha, where we're planning to go in the coming months, Bengal, we are helping catalyze, bring together people who will work at the local level, and we are hoping that there will be state level action, ongoing state level action in response to hate crime, and a politics which is trying to divide us.
Thank you very much, Harsh, for being with us.
Thank you.
We hope that we'll be able to partner you with your at least chronicling of what is happening.
We see Newsclick as a completely, as a very strong partner of this entire exercise. And I wouldn't want to go on the journey without Newsclick.
Thank you very much. This is all the time we have for Newsclick today. Do keep watching Newsclick, visit our webpage, and also look at our YouTube channel.